So hello all, welcome to the series of fan engagement motivation, where we are talking to some passionate IPL fans and trying to understand what motivates them to follow a specific IPL franchise very passionately. So in this series, today we have Krishna with us. He's a passionate Sunrisers Hyderabad fan who runs a social media channel and brings amazing Sunrisers Hyderabad related content. So Krishna, welcome to this show.
Thanks, Deep.
Right. So tell me how your journey as a Sunrisers Hyderabad fan started. Where do you belong?
I belong to Mumbai, but I have started my SRH campaign when SRH came into the IPL in 2012. That time I loved SRH very much because the David Warner was the captain of Sunrisers Hyderabad, and he has a brilliant batting skills, and he's a brilliant captain for Sunrisers Hyderabad when he led the 2016 IPL trophy for us.
Right. So I have a curious question in mind. So you said that you are from Mumbai. So why didn't you follow Mumbai Indians, because they were so successful back then?
Actually, I stay in Mumbai, but I support SRH because SRH is my one of the favorite teams, because all my favorite players are in Sunrisers Hyderabad. And in Mumbai Indians, I don't much follow them because I don't like that team very much. I am a true SRH fan. My all favorite players are in SRH: Kane Williamson, David Warner, Jonny Bairstow, Rashid Khan, Bhuneshwar Kumar. All are my favorite players in Sunrisers Hyderabad. That's why I follow Sunrisers Hyderabad so much.
Right. So what does David Warner mean to you? David Warner has a brilliant presence, and every Sunrisers Hyderabad fan likes David Warner so much. So
yeah, because he's a very cool person and he's a very calm person also. But then also he brings some much aggression in the matches. But his dance swags, his dance move, his batting skills, and everything of his personal life also is much brilliant, and all people like David Warner so much.
Right. And that David Warner's 100th celebration, so usually fans compare that with Bahubali's sword.
Yeah, because he jumps and he celebrates the 100. And we have seen in Australia also, when he scores a century, he celebrates and makes the crowd so much happy that all the fans follow David Warner so much.
Right. So when we see Sunrisers Hyderabad, they have this calmness of Kane Williamson. Whenever they feel, they show that kind of calmness. But they have that aggression also in their play because they have players like David Warner and Jonny Bairstow. So do you think they have this perfect mixture of calmness and aggression?
Yeah, absolutely. Because Jonny Bairstow and David Warner are one of the most valuable players of the opener in Sunrisers Hyderabad. And that's why in Kane Williamson is one of the legend batsmen in the world and in the New Zealand team also. And I personally like Kane Williamson also a lot, very much, because he has this calm, composed person, and his captaincy skills are also very much brilliant. And he has won Orange Cap in 2016 also.
Right. So since you talked about Orange Cap, so there is this trend that goes with David Warner. He won the Orange Cap in 2015.
Three times, yeah. 2015, 2017, and 2019, yeah.
So it's 2021, another odd year. So do you think he will win it again this time?
As a brilliant captain he is, I hope he will win one more Orange Cap.
Right.
And he will be the odd person of the IPL. Every time odd number he comes.
Yes. That's so true. So you're wearing the Sunrisers Hyderabad jersey.
Yeah.
It's in orange color. They call themselves the Orange Army.
Orange Army, yeah.
Right. And they have this song, Go, Go, Go.
Go, Orange Army.
Right. But this time they have started a new hashtag, which is hashtag
Orange is nothing.
Yeah.
Nothing. What does that
mean to you as a fan?
As a fan, I mean that orange is nothing means no other color should come in case of orange. Only orange should be the color of the sunrise in Hyderabad, as they suit the colors very much. That's why they are telling orange is nothing.
Right. And whenever we talk about Sunrise Hyderabad, so their fans are very passionate during their home games. They hear a lot of Telugu songs during the games. And we see David Warner dancing to those Telugu songs. So do you think that even though Sunrise Hyderabad have overseas players, but those overseas players connect really well with the local fans?
Yeah, because they have much development in their skills. And in the local fans also, as we see the Chennai Super Kings, MS Dhoni is called the Thala of the Chennai crowd. And the Chennai crowd also loves MS Dhoni very much, as MS Dhoni also likes the crowd. And because both are the South Indian states, and Hyderabad people also love their fans, love their cricketers very much. And the cricketers also love their fans very much. And their connection is very good.
Right. So you compared Sunrisers with Chennai. So there is another common thing. So if you observe that they both develop their social media content a lot in their local language. So do you think this is one of the reasons why the local fans connect really well with the franchise?
Yeah, because the local because the fans who are there in the stadium, they always support their team, and the team also gets motivated very much, and they move further with the good run scores and good wickets they pick up. That's why their fans are called the most cheerful fans in the stadium, whoever comes to see the match.
Right. So that's so true. So Sunrisers Hyderabad, they have focused a lot in improving their bowling strength. So season after season, we see that their bowling is always among one of the best bowling strength teams in the IPL. So do you think that their bowling is one of the reasons why they have been so successful?
Yeah, because they have the world-class bowlers in their team. And Rashid Khan is the number two T20 bowler. And for the Sunrisers Hyderabad, is the number one spinner. And in the spinning tracks, Rashid Khan is the very most successful wicket takers for Sunrisers Hyderabad. And in the fast bowling department, we have Bhuneshwar Kumar, who has been successful in the England and T20 series, and is a very he's called the swing king of the cricket, and he's one of the most successful wicket takers for Sunrisers Hyderabad also. And T Natarajan is the very Yorker specialist. We have seen in recent matches last time that he bowled such a spells that no other batsman can play him. The one of the greatest batsmen, AB de Villiers, can also face him because he is such a specialist bowler in Yorker styles.
Right. So they have a really brilliant bowling attack this season with Rashid Khan, Bhuvneshwar Kumar, T Natarajan, probably,
and Mujibur Rahman.
Right. So, but if we see how Sunrisers Hyderabad have won their titles, so during their Deccan Chargers days, they had one Australian opener, Adam Gilchrist, and they had one Australian called Andrew Simons in the middle order in 2016 when they won.
And in the Deccan Chargers, they have Rohit Sharma also as the opener.
Right. So, if we see that in 2016, when they won, they had David Warner and Moises Henriques in the squad. So this time also, they had David Warner and Mitchell Marsh in the squad, but March is not available this time. So how
because
much?
Last season also, he got injured and he was not fit for the other remaining matches for Sunrisers Hyderabad. And now he is not more able fit for Sunrisers. That's why we have replaced him with Jason Roy. Because Jason Roy is suitable for the one down opening position, and he can start hitting the boundary, and the opponent bowlers can get more pressure to face him.
Right. So that's very true. Jason Roy is an amazing attacking batsman from England. But do you see that this time the English fan base will be somewhat divided between Rajasthan and Sunrisers, because now they have two prominent faces, Johnny Bairstow and Jason Roy in Sunrisers, and Josh Butler and Ben Stokes.
Yeah, but it will not be much, because they are all playing for their own franchisee, and they will all represent their own teams. That I don't think so that it will more affect on their personal things and for the England team that they are divided. I don't think so, because they are playing for their own teams as well. So we should respect that they are playing for their own teams, and they will if they get chances in any other teams, then they can definitely get more chances in the international leagues and the big bashes as well.
Right. So coming to Sunrisers, they have I guess probably one of the best support staffs. When you look, they have Tom Moody, they have Trevor Bayliss, they have
VVS Laxman.
Yeah. So do you think that having such kind of support staff helps the young Indian players a lot, especially Abdul Samad, Priyam Garg, Abhishek Sharma?
Yeah, absolutely. Because when Priyam Garg, Abdul Samad will go into more international events, when they will face the different country's opponent, then they will get more trainings from this because Tom Moody and VVS Lakshmi is one of the most experienced person in the IPL and for the Sunrisers Hyderabad. That's why they have got so much brilliant talents coming up for Sunrisers Hyderabad. And I hope that they will be one of the good batsmen as Virat Kohli and Rohit Sharma, Priyam Garg and Abdul Samad. Abdul Samad will be the replacement of Hardik Pandya, and Priyam Garg will be the replacement of Virat Kohli or Rohit Sharma, because Priyam Garg has a good talent in his batting skills. I've seen in last recent matches for Sunrisers Hyderabad.
Right. So last season, Sunrisers bought three exciting young players. Priyam Garg, he got plenty of chances. Abdul Samad, yeah, he also got plenty of chances. But unfortunately, Virat Singh couldn't get to play so many games. But this season, he is in brilliant form. He has performed really well in the domestic games. So do you see Virat Singh playing a big role in Sunrisers Hyderabad in this particular season?
Yeah, I think that he will be a big role. As if we have to see the form of Abhishek Sharma. If Abhishek Sharma doesn't perform well, then Virat Singh can replace Abhishek Sharma in the batting lineup.
Right. So probably we will see another Virat making his name into Indian.
Yeah.
Right.
But difference between Virat Singh and Virat Kohli are they both are different left. Virat Kohli is a right-hand batsman, and Virat Singh is a left-hand batsman. So that will make the difference in the Indian team if Virat Singh comes in the Indian team.
Right. So when we talk about the Sunrisers Hyderabad, so they have very household names in their overseas stars. But when we talk about their Indian contingent, we hardly find any star Indian player apart from Bhuvneshwar Kumar and Manish Pandey. So do you think that their Indian core is somewhat weaker than other franchises?
Yeah, but that's not a big problem, because we want a team who is strong and win the IPL. We don't want to see that Indian core is strong or foreign core is strong. We are just focusing on that our team should win the reach the finals and lift the trophy. And if the Indian players are weak in the Indian team as well, they will develop their more skills, as we have good coaches in our back side. So I don't think that Indian core is, we should tell them they are weak.
Right. So, coming to the Indian batting and Indian bowling or Indian players in the team. So, for most of the franchises, we see that they have some local players in the franchise. For example, Punjab has some Punjab players, Chennai has some Tamil Nadu players. But in Hyderabad, recently, we have not seen a star Andhra or star Telangana player playing for the franchise. So, do you think that affects the fan base?
No, I don't think so, because we have more fan bases, and I'm also part of Sunrisers Hyderabad fan group. So, there are more fan people from Hyderabad. They are all from Hyderabad. So, I don't think that will affect the Sunrisers Hyderabad fan base, because we want that all over the world should support Sunrisers Hyderabad, and our team should get very good recognition in the world.
Right. So that's very true, because you have players from England, you have players from Australia, you have players from New Zealand, you have players from West Indies.
See, so, I'm from Mumbai and I'm supporting Sunrisers Hyderabad, and different people are there. They stay in Mumbai, and one person is also there from Mumbai and he supports the Rajasthan Royals. So that is not a problem, that whichever part of the world you are, we can support our team very much. If you're a true fan, then you should support your team very good.
Right. And but in India, we usually see that fans either they tend to follow a franchise who is performing really well, or they follow a franchise where they see a star Indian name like Virat Kohli, Rohit Sharma or MS Dhoni. So do you think that this should happen, or what are your thoughts about it?
Yeah, all are telling that my favorite team is Chennai Super Kings because MS Dhoni is my favorite batsman. We can't tell that. If you love that team, very good. And only MS Dhoni is not the player in Chennai Super Kings. We have very good players in that Chennai Super Kings squad. Whichever they have a squad, they have such a brilliant batsmen. Faf du Plessis, Ravindra Jadeja. They are all experienced persons. So we can't tell that I like MS Dhoni, so I support Chennai Super Kings. It should come up from your heart that you are a true fan of that team, particular team.
Right. And do you believe that a team's performance drives fans? For example, Mumbai Indians is winning so many cups. That's why so many people follow Mumbai Indians. And that's why Bangalore has somewhat less fan base as compared to Mumbai, even though Virat Kohli and AB de Villiers are there.
I don't think so, because you're saying the truth that Mumbai Indians wins the more cups and they are more fan bases. That is not the case. Which team performance is bad also, you should support that team and encourage your team that you can win the IPL title. That Sunrisers has won only one IPL title, and we are not comparing that Mumbai has won five and we are won only one. We support our team from our heart, and we know that our team will do this, well in the IPL 2021, and we will lift the trophy in 2021.
Right. So I think you are talking from the bottom of your heart, and all your emotions can be seen when you talk about Sunrisers Hyderabad. So when we talk about Sunrisers Hyderabad and how they have progressed over the years, so Sunrisers Hyderabad's progress can be compared with David Warner's progress. And David Warner has been named as one of the most consistent players in the history of IPL, with some consecutive 400 plus series.
500 plus. 500. He has more 500 plus run scores in the full history of IPL. And no other batsman can compare with David Warner, because in every IPL season, he scores more 500 runs for his team. And he tells the world that I am the best batsman in the IPL history. And AB de Villiers is a 360 of a full IPL history, because he's a most dangerous player for RCB. And for Sunrisers Hyderabad, we have David Warner, who is the opening combination and who can score runs and win the team for us.
Right. So, for a fan, how important is it to see consistent faces in the squad? Because we have seen that after a season ends, Sunrisers Hyderabad, they don't usually release so many players or buy so many players like other franchises. They believe in having a consistent squad. So how much that helps you as a fan to connect with the franchises, because you see familiar faces season after season?
Yeah, that's true of Sunrisers Hyderabad, that they keep the squad that way only, because they don't release more players, because they have belief in their players. And they know that our players, our boys can do very much in the next IPL seasons. That's why other IPL teams, they don't believe that our player is the first day. DC bought Trent Bolt, and after that, DC released Trent Bolt because Trent Bolt was not giving wickets for DC. I don't think so. That is a case. You should have belief in your players that your player will perform very well in the IPL seasons.
Right. And the way SRH management backs their players, it's very rare to see that happening in other franchisees. Probably Mumbai and Chennai are other franchisees which back their players so much, and that's why these are one of the franchisees that are liked by fans so much. So when you have players like Kane Williamson and David Warner,
yeah,
do you believe that I even if you are not fan of such a team, but you can't hate such a team?
Yeah, but Kane Williamson and David Warner, they can't release them. I don't, because some commentators were saying that if the MS Dhoni retires, then Kane Williamson will be the captain of Chennai Super Kings. I don't believe that Kane Williamson will be traded to Chennai Super Kings, because he is one of the best batsmen. He's a backbone of Sunrisers Hyderabad. And if the pressure comes for Sunrisers Hyderabad, he is only the person who can be taken off that pressure. Because last time also versus Delhi Capitals, the eliminator, he only released the half pressure of the team. And Sunrisers Hyderabad was going to win only, but last moment Kane Williamson got out. That's and I don't think so that Kane Williamson will be released from Sunrisers Hyderabad.
Right, that makes complete sense as a fan and as a cricket enthusiast, because you can't release such players. They have such a great impact,
yeah,
on the game and on the fan base. So now coming to an interesting part of this episode. So Sunrisers Hyderabad, they usually combine Tollywood and cricket together in order to engage better with the fans. So if you have to pick four overseas players of Sunrisers Hyderabad and combine them, or you can tell that which South Indian actor will best fit for that particular player?
Bahubali will be fit by David Warner. As I've seen him, that he was doing that Bahubali this thing also, and he was making that. I'm also second Bahubali of the Bahubali part. I think David Warner will fit for the Bahubali.
Right. And for Johnny Bairstow?
Johnny Bairstow, I think that Prabhas will fit for Johnny Bairstow.
Right. And now the interesting one, Kane Williamson.
See, I only trust on David Warner because he dances such a swag, and he has such a swag, and he encourages the crowd of the full Hyderabad fans. And Kane Williamson, I don't think that he dances and he swags the crowd and he entertains the crowd. I don't think Kane Williamson will be fit for any other, because he's such a cool person that we can't tell that any aggressive role will be fit for him. David Warner has such a aggression on his field and on his for his team that I don't think that Kane Williamson will be fit for any roles.
Right. So what about the magician, the Rashid Khan?
Rashid Khan will be the magician. Because Rashid Khan, I don't think so, because he's a very good googly spinner, and Rashid Khan will be the aimer who will aim the opponents, and he will attack the opponents with his bowling skills.
Right. So Sunrisers Hyderabad, they call themselves the Orange Army.
Yeah.
So, apart from Sunrisers, we see most of the teams, they have blue colored jersey, so they can't call themselves the Blue Army. So do you think that this is a unique feature of Sunrisers Hyderabad?
No, it's not a unique, it's a good feature for Sunrisers Hyderabad. And the song, which is Go 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 Orange Army, that's as really made the Sunrisers Hyderabad fan and other team fans as well. They have been proud that we have got this song for our team. Because this, because any other fans will also like to dance on this song, because this song has such an encouragement and such an enthusiasm. That's why we have selected this song, and I'm proud that we have this song. I also feel like dancing from my bed, and I also feel that wow, my team has got such a good song in my
right
SRH camp.
Right. I think that's one of the best IPL theme songs for any particular franchise. It has
Yeah.
that those elements of Tollywood music industry, those dance beats, and it's very, very engaging also. So coming to the last question. So do you believe that this time Sunrisers has all that it takes to go and win the title?
Yeah, I have full hopes that Sunrisers Hyderabad will win the title because they have such a good batting depth, they have such a good bowling unit, they are such a good all-rounders. They are very well balanced team in this IPL, and every commentators are telling that this year IPL first team who will qualify for the playoffs is Sunrisers Hyderabad. Because and I as a Sunrisers Hyderabad fan, I hope they will go into the finals and the lift. For the lift the trophy once again.
Right. So, as a fan, do you think that expectations are very high from your franchise and
Yeah.
also from you as a fan to support your team more this season?
Yeah, I'm very excited to support my team because I am not overconfident. Because if I will become more confident, my team will also become. I will not be able to support team properly. That's why I don't want to comment that my team will be the winners. I want to say that my team performs well and they reaches the final. That's only my take on the Sunrisers Hyderabad.
Right. I think that's a brilliant take on Sunrisers Hyderabad. And I hope your dreams will come true and Sunrisers Hyderabad and David Warner will lift the trophy this season.
Orange Army.
Go, 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 Orange Army. So
Yeah.
thanks for coming on this particular show and sharing your views. It was really nice talking to you.
Thank you, Deep.
Thanks.